Welcome to MeMe's Kitchen. Well, y'all, summer continues. It's good and hot today right here in South Carolina and just a beautiful day. And you can tell, though, that it's beginning to change a little. So we know that fall is around the corner, but you know what? Hold on to that pumpkin and all that spice because, wait a minute, summer is still here. So we're celebrating summer. Y'all, today, I think a lot of minds and hearts are on the Queen's funeral. And she just lived such a beautiful life. And I thought today, in honor of her memory, that we would do an English dessert. So we kind of did some research, and KK helped me, and we found the recipe. Well, the recipe that we found is called sandwich cake, but originally it was called sponge cake, and it started out with Queen Victoria, and she was the one that had this every afternoon with her spot of tea. And so we thought, well, hey, you know what, that'll be fun just to make it. So we decided to gather it together. Well, y'all, as it turns out, the explanation says that it's not sponge in the way that we as Americans think of a sponge cake. When you say that, you probably think angel food. It's not like angel food texture. Really, it's more like a pound cake texture. And so in the ingredients, I love this. It calls for King Arthur flour. Well, I couldn't find King Arthur flour. Not at least where I shop, and that would be Walmart most of the time, and I guess they aren't into that sort of thing. But I have seen it. I mean, it's available, but I just couldn't find it today. So the ingredients, y'all, are very simple. It's unsalted butter, sugar, flour, and 4 eggs. And that's it. And so once we make that and those layers cool, then it has a filling in it that really makes it sound delicious. So the first thing we are going to do is to put our unsalted butter in here. And y'all know this makes me happy because it has 2 sticks of butter. So we'll put the 2 sticks of butter in there. The cup of sugar, and that's granulated sugar, just your regular sugar. Put that in there, and we are going to let that mix really well until it's kind of light and fluffy. And I have already set my oven on 350 degrees. So when that preheats and that we'll let this mix a little bit and then we'll be right back. Okay, I think that's good. Those are well blended.
And that butter was?
Oh yeah, I'm sorry. The butter was room temperature, very soft. So we're gonna add our eggs one at a time. And it says to let it completely incorporate before you add your next one. So y'all, it's 4 eggs. All right, that's number 2, and that's number 4. Okay, we'll let those mix really good. Okay, y'all, it also has a teaspoon of vanilla flavoring, so I'm just gonna pour that in there. Now, 2 cups of self-rising flour. We'll just kind of put this in a little bit at a time. And we'll be right back. Okay, I've put all my flour in there. Now, this makes 2 layers. Now, in the recipe, it says 8-inch pans or 9-inch pans. I am using 9-inch pans because that's what I use to make my cakes. This
did them with butter.
Yes, and I just did that with butter. You could spray them with Pam or whatever you'd like to, well, Pam for bacon. Now, let's look at this dough here. batter. And y'all, when you put the flour in it, don't over beat it. So let's, now look how thick that is. Whoo, that's thicker than really than a pound cake. So we'll put these, we'll try to divide it evenly so we'll have two even layers. Okay, we're gonna smooth this out so that it fills our whole pan. Okay, our oven is ready, 350 degrees. So I'm gonna put these right in here. Now, it says to bake them about 22 minutes, but my pan is bigger. So I'm gonna set my timer on, I'm gonna set my timer on, if I can get it right, let's do 18 minutes. And I will check it and make sure that it doesn't overbake because we don't want it dry. Okay, y'all. 10 seconds, we on the countdown here. We're getting ready to blast off. We're gonna check this thing and I can see through my glass here and it pretty much looks like it's done. So you can kind of really tell. All right, we're gonna stick that in there. All right, that came out clean. And that came out clean, but I can tell by the way it went in there. I am going to cook this 2 more minutes. See now, it is pulling away from the side of the pan, and that's really what you want it to do. But I'm gonna stick that back in there for just about 2 minutes. Just make sure that top is well done. So we'll be right back. Okay. Oh yes. Now, you put these on a rack to cool. So we'll set it right there.
They smell so good.
Ooh, they smell good and they look so pretty. And look how even they are. I love that because when we put them together, they won't be lopsided or anything. Now, the reason you let them cool completely is because we're gonna put whipped cream between these. And so these have to be really cool because if not, you know what happens if you put whipped cream between them. So we just go let them cool there. And you know what? KK and I are going to get a pedicure. Okay, we're back from the pedicure, y'all. Now see, we're getting ready. Kinley and Graham are getting married this weekend, this Saturday. Oh, we're so excited. And so we have to have everything just right. So we knew we could get our toes done today. We'll have our manicure later on. Okay, we're getting ready now to assemble this. These are completely cool. I went ahead and turned one out and got it right there on the thing. So now we're going to whip our cream. And this is 1 cup of heavy whipping cream. The actual recipe says 2/3 to 3/4 cup. But since I did a 9-inch layer, I'm going to do a whole cup. So you don't need to hear all this noise, so we're gonna whip this cream up. Okay, y'all, it says to add about 2 tablespoons of sugar. So we're guesstimating here. That's about 2 tablespoons. And I'm sure all of you know that you don't overbeat this stuff, you'll have butter. So, all right, that looks good right there. Okay, now the first thing we do is we spread the strawberry jam. Now, in England, sometimes they use marmalade, but their preferred choice is the strawberry jam. Now, this is strawberry jam that I made this summer. It's in my cookbook. So you can go in this called freezer jelly. And it's so easy to make. Y'all, you just love it. And then when you get those good hot biscuits or toast or pancakes or whatever, you will be so glad that you took the time to make you some of this jelly. So we're gonna put plenty on here. Ooh, y'all, the queen ate this every day with her afternoon tea. I don't see how she didn't get to be big as a house. Okay, we just go dollop this on here. I've already started. I wanted to make sure what it was gonna do, to tell you the truth. All right. So we'll just cover this whole thing here with whipped cream. Ooh, boy. This makes for a rich dessert. I would have to say in the recipe, it says that this is not a cake, an eloquent, I think it said cake. But this is just an everyday dessert to be used like at tea time. Okay. Now, put a second layer on there and then just sprinkle this top with, and y'all, this is just a little sifter and I just put my powdered sugar in there and you just more or less cover the top of it with powdered sugar. Okay, y'all, this is what it looks like assembled. Kayleen said I got carried away with my powdered sugar, and I probably did. But anyway, it looks beautiful. And so what we're going to do now, y'all, this is my English china. It's called Fontainebleau. And we have us a spot of tea here. And we're going to cut this thing, and we're just going to see exactly. Now, you know, when they said when they first started making this, they made it in a long loaf pan. And then they cut it kind of like little finger sandwiches, which would be beautiful too. But we're going to cut this now, and we're going to see exactly what it looks like when it's cut. Okay, y'all, this is what it looks like. I believe I could get used to eating that every afternoon. It certainly looks delicious, and I'll be trying it here in a minute with my tea. I would like to say that the queen was an admired person. And one of the things that really let me know where she stood spiritually recently was published that one of her chaplains was talking with her about the second coming. And she got very interested and she said, oh, I pray that the second coming will happen in my lifetime. And he said, well, why is that? And she said, because I would love to lay my crown at the feet of Jesus. Oh my, that was so powerful. And that let me know exactly where she stood and where and what she understood about the gospel. So y'all, we've got a busy week. We're getting ready for the wedding and everybody's just so excited, you know, all the activities that go on with that. And guess what? I am making 18 dozen chocolate chip cookies as part of the reception. That's their favorite and that's what they wanted. And you better believe that's what they're gonna get from me. And so I'll be making cookies all day Friday and Saturday and getting ready for that wedding Saturday afternoon. I hope y'all have a good rest of the week. Thank y'all all for all your beautiful comments and for the friendship that we have established here with this page. Oh, y'all, it's just, it's wonderful. And I thank you for all that you say. And it just adds more to my life, to tell you the truth. So have a good rest of the week, and everybody, shine for Jesus.